Previously on The Mole, 9 players began a series of tasks raising money for the pot that the winner will eventually take home. The current pot is at $57. However, one of these players is the mole, hired by me to secretly sabotage the group's efforts. It's up to the players to figure out who the mole is, because at the end of each round they have to take a 10-question quiz on the mole's identity. The player with the lowest score in the quiz is executed and must leave the game immediately. So far, Michelle, Joey, John, Sarah, Sam, and Anna have fallen victim to the mole.
Congratulations, you guys are the final four in the game, but as you all know, one of you four is the mole. So we're gonna continue with test number 9, but who has the best eye for art? You?
Yeah.
Okay, so come with me. Pick one piece of art from this 8-picture gallery that we've set up. This piece?
Yeah.
Okay.
The picture is just of a woman, just her face.
Short, like, shoulder length, or like short, like, or like pixie cut. Hello?
Your time has started, go.
Oh, are you kidding?
Time is up.
That's it? Okay.
Yep. You have less than 3 minutes to draw on it.
The binder? Oh, yeah, I don't even know if they're doing it anymore. Okay, these are good.
Good?
Yeah.
Okay. We had one person choose one of these 8 photos, another person give instructions on the photo that was chosen, and the third person, Anna, draw it. So here's her drawing. You have 1 minute to try to match it with the picture. Okay? And Gabe, which picture did you choose? You chose that one. Congratulations.
Yay.
So you guys got $6 added to the pot.
That was a little suspicious that Marissa would choose something so difficult because the picture definitely could have been Marilyn Monroe. I feel like she could have chosen an easier picture.
She picked one of the hardest pictures for me to draw. Anna's the least one, I suspect, but then I'm like, maybe I should watch out for her.
So for this task, you have to split up into 2 groups. The 3 people who are the smartest and the 1 dumb person in the group.
Well, maybe because like Anna's
the
least experienced.
Yeah, okay, I'll be the dumbest. I'm done with that.
Okay.
You thinking?
I didn't call her the dumbest, okay? I said she was the less experienced.
So it's up to you to pick 6 puzzles for them, and for each puzzle that they solve in their 10-minute period, $1 will be added to the pot. However, if they don't solve 4 or more puzzles, you will get an exemption.
Look at hers first.
There's like nothing on
it. Yeah.
That one's a long reading one. Okay.
You guys did solve 4, so she does not get an exemption and will have to take this quiz.
I didn't get an exemption because I really want to be in the final 3. So I'm upset.
It's a little suspicious that she would just give us all the hard ones, but...
Anna.
Oh,
Anna,
no.
I'm sorry.
Oh,
you are the 6th victim.
3 remain, but only 1 will win. The one who answers the question, who is the mole? Can you figure it out? Who is the mole?
Alright, congratulations. You guys are the top 3, and one of you is about to go home with $57+, and someone is the mole who's going to go home with the remainder of the $100 that the winner does not take. So now it's time for your final task. So for this, you have to choose 1 player who is the easiest to read. So go ahead and choose that 1 player between yourself.
I'm not saying this time because you guys made me mad. No, you didn't make
what?
Me mad. You didn't make me
what?
Mad. That's
what
I meant to say.
What?
No. That's not what I meant to say.
But that's what you said.
You guys thought I was being mean. That's what I meant to say. Because
that?
I picked
I
Anna.
Did.
I'm not
picking
this time.
I
I'll be the one person then.
You'll be the one person?
Yeah.
All right.
Your part of the task is you're gonna have to fill out this 8-question questionnaire answering either Alina or Marissa for each one.
Okay. Wow. Whoa! Who made up these questions? This is,
Okay.
So, Alina, Marissa, we had Gabe fill out a questionnaire asking questions similar to the ones in the opinion survey that we did yesterday. And he had to answer with one of your names. So some of these questions that he answered is, an example would be, who's more likely to cheat on their significant other? That's not one of them that we chose. So after we ask you the 3 questions, each answer will take us to a location, getting closer and closer to a final location. And if you answer all 3 correctly, then you'll find Gabe, and $12 will be added to the pot. For each question that you answer correctly, however, if you only answer 2 correct, it'll be $3 per question, so you get $6, or if you only answer 1 correct, you get $3. Both Marissa and Alina are bitten by a venomous snake, and you only have enough anti-venom to save 1 player. Who would you save?
Oh, I don't know. Like, Gabe would decide.
Who would Gabe save? Not,
oh, I don't know.
Talk to each other
about
it. I don't know.
I sent that to him in English last year. I was gonna say it.
You're gonna say Marissa?
Yeah.
Okay. Then we're going to head to the basement.
Now, the next question will either take us into this room or he'll be in one of these closets. So, the next question we ask Gabe is, who's more likely to end up in pornography? Marissa or Alina?
Me. Wait, you think it's gonna be you?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
So you guys answer
Wait,
Marissa?
Why would you think it was you?
I don't know. Okay, if you think it's you, we'll go with you. Okay,
you think
we'll
it's
go,
Marissa?
We'll go with Marissa.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That means that Gabe is in the undone side of the basement. Okay, the last question we asked Gabe is, who would have less people attend their funeral? Alina or Marissa?
Yeah, right? Yeah.
You think it's Alina?
Yeah.
Okay. If it's Alina, then Gabe will be under the stairs. So why don't you guys go and check if Gabe's under the stairs?
Oh my god.
Gabe, come out.
Come out, Gabe. Congratulations. Together, you guys earned $12, which means the final pot for the winner is at $69.
Last task, really uncomfortable. I had to answer really uncomfortable questions. Yeah, that was rough. But somehow, they got all the answers right. So, I guess I'm pretty easy to read.
You guys are about to take your final execution quiz. It's 20 questions about the identity of the mole, and this time there'll be questions from everything that's happened from yesterday to right now. It's now time for the final execution quiz, 20 questions on the mole's identity. The player with the highest score on this quiz will win the game.
Why I would think Marissa is the mole is because a couple times throughout the game she acted selfishly, like taking the exemption, which took money out of the pot.
At this point, it's really 50-50, and I know I'm gonna have to make a decision soon, but I have these suspicions that it could be Marissa, but like the way she acts during the challenges, I feel like maybe it's not. And Alina's a little more like whatever, so that's suspicious, but she did get the first lock, and I don't think, we really didn't know what was going on. I mean, her getting that first one was definitely not suspicious, I guess, because obviously the mole wouldn't want that lock open, and it would have been really easy to just keep putting in the wrong combination, saying you got it right, that you had the right combination, so I don't really know what to think right now. To go back through the notes, look at everything.
Alina, I've had suspicions about the entire game, so I don't know, they're pretty high for her. And then Gabe, that one round where we could give it to, give the exemption to one person, or else we would, or else we didn't get like $5 or something. He could have just been doing that to draw suspicion to himself so that people would be, do bad on the quiz. So then again, I don't know.
And then why I would think it's Gabe's, because I didn't really expect him to make it this far, and the fact that he did seems suspicious.
I don't know if I should do like half one person and half the other, or just do it all one person.
This is it, the final three. Made it this far. You know, hopefully I can win. It would really suck to come all this way not to win, but you know, that's what it is.
It's really coming down to the wire now.
I think I played well. I mean, I made it to the top three, so I think I played well. And my strategy obviously worked.
I mean, at this point, it's like it's 50-50, because it's only one winner, one runner-up, and then it's the mole, so 50-50 is good odds, you know. If I was a casino game, I'd bet on me.
One of these players is about to win the $69, but first, let's take a look back at why each player is suspicious of being the mole.
I think it's Alina.
I'm most suspicious of that girl, Alina.
So you think Alina's the mole?
Oh yeah, definitely think Alina's the mole. And I'm kind of leaning more now towards Alina. She's my new target. Alina's probably my target because while she was doing the game, she was kind of, I mean, taking her time, but probably because she didn't know what she was doing. But, I don't know, I kind of took note of that, and Gabe kind of had to step in and help her out.
I'm thinking Alina, maybe, because she's been very under the radar lately. So I'm thinking maybe she would be...
The finders, they kept messing up our numbers. So I'm definitely thinking Marissa's one, because think about it, like, Craig, it trusts Marissa. So I think it could be Marissa.
And Marissa went fifth and she took the exemption.
Why did Marissa take the exemption? We all agreed that we wouldn't take it.
Yeah, Marissa's the bitch of the season.
Yeah.
She's like America, like if you had a vote for like your, like America had a vote for their favorite, like she'd be the last one that everyone would vote for.
I'm surprised that Marissa opted to take her notebook instead of the money, which makes me have more suspicions on her.
This is like not the first time she's not like taken like something for herself instead of the money, so it makes me kind of suspicious of her.
That was a little suspicious that Marissa would choose something so difficult, because the picture definitely could have been Marilyn Monroe. I feel like she could have chosen an easier picture.
She picked one of the hardest pictures for me to draw, so that makes me kind of suspicious.
Who is the mole?
Gabe Chan.
Okay, then we're going with Anna.
Yeah,
just say Anna.
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 I think John should
get it. Okay, then John.
Oh my god, he's being so suspicious.
John!
Right now.
Gabe was really mean. He like turned on everyone. I think it's him.
Gabe was very obviously like trying to work against us. Like I'm still kind of leaning towards Gabe. Only because he stayed pretty quiet. And you know, he doesn't, he doesn't like offer any opinion when we do tasks. Like if it was hard or you know, like anything like that. Or he doesn't like assign himself a position.
I didn't really expect him to make it this far. And the fact that he did seems suspicious.
On the test and it says, is the mole male or female? It's yeah. Like, but what if Gabe's the mole? And yeah. I'm getting that question wrong every single time. So.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's so annoying.
Yeah.
Welcome back, executed players. So now we're gonna call down the winner of the game.
Okay. All right. Send down the person with the number one inside their envelope. Yes. All right. This is the winner of the Mole Season 1.
Give.
Oh.
No. I won.
Wait, I won.
You won. You won $69.
Yeah.
Now we're gonna call down the mole. Alright, now send down the person with the number 3 in their envelope.
Wait, who's coming down right now?
The mole.
Gabe. The mole is not sitting down.
It's not Gabe. It's not Gabe. It's Alina.
No.
Alina. Come down, mole.
I knew it from the start.
I'll share the money with you.
Gabe, you're the runner-up. I'm sorry. Okay, so going back to yesterday when everyone arrived, we asked you guys to fill out the first thought sheet, and only one person thought that Alina was the mole, and that was Marissa.
Wow.
And Marissa actually voted for Alina on the quiz every single time that she took it. And she was the only person, except Sam, at one point.
Yeah.
You voted for Alina as the mole, but then you switched to Gabe. And once you switched to Gabe, you got out. And Gabe voted for Alina in this final round. Those were the only other times that someone voted for Alina on the quiz. And three people thought that our first person executed was going to be the winner. Michelle, Sam, and Sarah all thought Michelle was going to win.
Even though she was the first person out.
And four people thought Gabe was the mole to start off. That was Sam, Joey, Michelle, and Sarah. And two people thought it was Anna. One person thought it was John. One person thought it was Marissa. And one person thought it was Alina. So, Michelle, when you first got out, do you remember who you put down on the quiz?
I put Marissa.
Yes, you did. And that was
the
last quiz. As the mole. So, Michelle and Joey, you guys tied with someone on the first quiz, and that was Sarah. But Sarah took it the fastest.
Nice.
And I forget, do you remember who you put down?
As
the mole? Yeah, because Sarah thought Sam was the mole the entire time. And then got out.
Did you get to the lions?
Sam put Sarah was the mole.
No, I lied
too.
Yeah.
Oh, you lied?
Yeah.
Oh my god!
Yes, no.
Did anyone else form alliances in this game? Joey? With Michelle?
I'd like to point out that I made two alliances in this game, one with Anna and one with Joey.
I didn't have much faith in her. Yeah, obviously she's gonna get out first because I knew she
was sneaky, but Joey was also very good for pouring out information.
John, you put Anna as the mole when you got out. Why'd you think Anna was the mole?
I don't know.
Just didn't know. So after the first quiz, John and Sarah had the most votes for being the mole from the quiz. Then after round two, it was John and Anna. Then after round three, it was Sam, Sarah, and Alina. Then after round four, it was Gabe. After round five, it was Anna again. And after round six, it was Alina. Marissa was really the only one who caught
on
until the end.
When we first got our notebooks, we all started writing down notes immediately, and Alina didn't even open her notebook. And I was like, that's really sketchy.
I don't think I wrote that.
Okay, so Alina, you were the mole. Tell us a little bit about like what you did and the sabotage and everything.
Okay. First and second round, I actually tried so I could take suspicions off of me.
Mm.
The third one, with the charades, I tried to act like I didn't know the movies, but they ended up getting them. Except for one of them, which was
Rugrats Hanukkah.
Rugrats Hanukkah, which was really hard. I was like crawling. What was the fourth one?
The fourth was the trust me one, where Marissa took the
exemption. Oh, I took the $2 to take suspicions off of me.
Yeah. Okay, so the next one was envelope bingo.
Yeah, I pretended I didn't know what was going on, and then Gabe took over.
Yeah.
I literally just let him do the whole thing, so then he solved it. What was the sixth one?
Throwing around opinions, yes.
I felt like I knew the answers for all of them, and then
Alina was the last one to take the survey downstairs, so we showed her all the answers before you guys went back upstairs, so she knew everyone.
The flamingo one?
Yeah.
I actually tried, because that would be obvious if I just quit.
Yeah.
The eighth one was today?
Yeah, that was just the one to fight for the notebook. But
I tried on that one too.
Oh, match the picture where you were in the dark.
Oh yeah, I was trying to make all the, like I was trying to describe it very generally so that you had to pick it, Gabe.
Yeah.
I thought you were gonna pick the Marilyn Monroe one. That's what I said, a very general picture.
Yeah.
And then the 10th one was.
Where you had to pick the smartest and the dumb person.
Oh, I knew. I like knew all the riddles. Not all of them, but I knew. Good amount.
You knew the one with like the hobo.
Yeah, I knew that one. I just did that.
And then the last task you didn't really sabotage.
No,
right? That was too obvious. Alright, well, congratulations, Marissa, and cast of season one. hopefully we'll see some of you guys back.
That's the
moment
we wanted. Sam. It's the only.
In the back.
So how do you feel about the prospects of $31?
$31? What can I buy with that? I don't know. $31 is nice. It's a net gain of $21. I could buy a video game with that. Yeah. Or a shirt, but I don't need any more clothes.
Would you consider donating it to charity?